arrive at your destination.
So when this thing goes to normal speed, do we get audio at the end of the warp speed video? There you go, there's one right at the front there.
Yeah, this one.
That looks good to me, that's where I'd be parking.
Is that a park?
Probably not like that, other might be an idiot somewhere. Blowing through the hole.
Which way? Sure, that's right.
Yes.
Right, left.
Taking us to the campground.
Turn left onto Beach Road. Turn left onto Naralu Road. Take the next left onto National Route 1.
Heading to Exmouth. 3 hours, 27 minutes, 340 kilometres. To the left. Diver Mandy is driving.
Continue on National Route 1 for 123 kilometres.
Roadhouse before Exmouth, 300 k's off.
Nice.
Oh, so it goes blue on the crescent. Right, so now we've just passed Turquoise Bay on our way to Oyster Stacks for a snorkel. We're approaching Oyster Stacks for a snorkel at peak tide. Boy, does it look like peak hour with the traffic.
A lot of people got the same idea.
This is the Mesa campsite. It's the campers, Lagoon, Boaties, and Mandy. Having just walked from our camp at Ned's, a kilometre north. Nice. A few kite footers out. There's a kite foiler doing its thing at Mesa, just south of Ned's, where we're camped. Seems to be plenty deep enough, certainly for boats and things. And this is kind of low tide. Tide's going to come in at 2:30 today. Not a very high one. Hello, boys and girls.
Hello.
Having a lovely holiday.
With a round hole in the middle. An 8-year-old kid named it after an Australian snack. What do you reckon he called it? That's it. Cheese or rock. There you go.
Yeah.
I'm on the West Coast supporter, mate.
Yeah, Andy Creek tour.
Bloody doggers look like
that. Ready to jump? I'm giving up on the AFL this year. I'll go up to Brisbane Broncos for the rugby. Tomorrow, mate, you're going to turn up for work? But I knew he was around because a lot of this cliff face here on that side where he is there.
Creek tour?
I did like the creek tour.
What did you see?
I saw this big lizard, the biggest lizard in Australia. I saw lots of different birds. I saw rock wallabies.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed it.
Very good. Off of Sandy Bay for a sail. Heights everywhere. Here we are at the visitors car park of the Messer campsite, just near Ned's. Andy's now going to do a big U-turn here and stop the vehicle, and I'll just poke my head around the corner, see who's sailing. Just take a second. that was Lakeside, allegedly. What was it like?
A bit shallow.
Dear. Osprey Bay, park number 7, quite near the Toot and the Bins. And we're going to go for a snorkel adventure. Come with us. She's in the Okay, we're at Lakeside on our last day for a nice look at the big critters.
Oh, I'm busy with your critters.
Maybe. So we're at the lighthouse. She's terrified.
I don't like it.
Doesn't like it. There's your lighthouse. I want to drive along the ridge road over there. Have tea where that goes.
We are at Lighthouse Point, is that right?
No, we're at the tip. At the end of the lighthouse road, there's Harold's Hotel. Cafe's over that side with one of them. Crabbing, and there's that boat sticking out of there. You got your camera to get a close up? Just had lunch at that little picnic table. Nice soup made by my darling on the side of the road at a 24-hour free camp called Barndale here, but some other name on Wikicamps. We'll take on a little tour. Leaving our lovely free bush camp at the Fortesque River Road. A little bit of water there. Nice family, been on the road for months. That's part of a year, 5 of them in there. 3 kids, a dog, 2 adults. Beautiful stargazing. Perfect night with our mozzie net up. And a lovely shower this morning. We're quite happy with that little find, even a good bin. Here we are leaving Maitland, the Maitland mail stop near the Maitland River. All it has is a chair and a road. Very Maitland. Okay, onward to Karratha for our morning coffee, poop and fuel stop at a roadhouse. Note the fire and flames coming out of the chimney over there. Crossing from the peninsula with, where were we?
Dampier.
Back to
Karratha.
And there's lovely community displays in the salt mines. There you have the shark. Here we have some indigenous persons.
Playing footy.
You will arrive at your destination.
Okay, we're turning into the De Grey rest area with built-in biohazard, free 24-hour shopping.
Stopping.
37.5 degrees, balmy.
You have arrived.
A little bit stinky in the cabin. And we've arrived. Let's have a tour. Okay, here we are at Canaldron, Cape Canaldron, the boat ramp site, 3 of 3. We'll take you to each 3. Mandy just used the lovely ablutions, sadly without water.
Very traumatising.
We'll now take you on a tour of the other campsites. And I'll check out the next hut. Be your hosting poster. Press time warp again. Okay, this is the middle of the 3 sites at Cape Canaldron. $12 vehicle entry and about $6 a night, so it's 30 something to stay a night here. Can clearly deal with a lot of people, so that's fine. Very tidal, so it's low tide at the moment, but it'll be high tide by 1 o'clock. Very interesting to see. No way could you launch a boat at the boat ramp we were just at right now, but who would try? We might just pull up next to the little shady park and have us a cup of tea. We'll be back later. sights at Cape Canaveral, or wherever we are. Looks like a lovely little beach point one there, where some guy's got his caravan set up. And there you can see the inner workings of the Toots, which are poorly maintained with no water, not even a brush bucket, nowhere near the quality of the Wooshloos at Exmouth area.
Apparently there's lots of midges here. So.
Yeah, midges, the full body armour protection.
Oh, go back. Looks pretty rough here to turn.
Okay, we might stop here for a little picnic and report back later. Pit stop featuring diesel, tyre pressure fix up, windscreen wash, water bottle fill, nice hot coffee and maybe treat ourselves to a breakfast, and a poo in a nice clean water flush toilet. And we're hoping we could bag ourselves an onion for tonight's barbecue, the only thing we neglected to buy at the greengrocer. As you can see, we're a little disappointed.
Very disappointed.
Had we had internet connectivity last night, we would have seen the red permanently closed notice next to this particular location. Never mind, we had a nice stop at Cape Canaveral, Cardu, Godofferin.
Something.
And we're now heading to our caravan park stop at 30 Mile Beach.
80 Mile Beach.
Last two nights in Norma the Van. Back to the last one. Mile Beach.
Oh, a little early.
At reception. Please drive on the road.
Can stop at the speed hump. Okay, we're here.
Here we are at 80 Mile Beach. It's a caravan park. The misses, the walkway, makes Sandy Bay look a little bit small. That looks pretty shallow and milky and weird. Stinking hot on the side of the road on our way to Broome. We've left the 80 mile nothing. It is 38 and a half degrees at 10:30 in the morning. And we've got about 250 km to go to get to civilization in Broome. Come with us on the journey.
Centurion Broom. We have made it. It's unbelievable. Well, not quite yet. 37 degrees and heading to Broome. And out of the van and into a resort. Oh yeah.